A very good morning to all of you on behalf of Columbia Institute of Pharmacy. I, Poonam Sahu, along with Dr. Vivekanand Mehar and Dr. Puspa Prasad Gupta. A heartily welcome to the e-workshop by Department of Pharmacology in the series of e-workshop organized by an institute. Now, let us move to e-workshop. The main objective to this e-workshop is complete overview of how to handle animal, route of drug administration, and dose calculation. Now, starting from animal handling. Before handling the animal, we take some precaution. First, pat or soothe the animal by slow, deliberate movement on their body. Overcrowding near cage should be avoided. Noise should be kept minimum. Don't hold too hard. Never agitate animal. It may become violent. The route of administration is largely depend on the property of the test substance and the objective of the experiment. All the administration should be performed with the knowledge of the chemical and physical characteristics of the substance. All routes have both demerit and merit, such as the absorption, viability, and metabolism of the substance. Consideration should be paid to the pH, viscosity, concentration, sterility, pyrogenicity, toxicity, as well as the existence of hazardous substance. Now, handling of mouse. Procedure first. One can handle it with the help of blunt forceps, as it is shown in figure, by grasping the skin behind the neck or body. This technique is used to transfer mice from cage to another. Should not hold too hard, it may injure the tissue. Procedure second, grasps the base of the tail with one hand and with the other grasps the loose skin behind the neck. You can do it as presented in the slide. Procedure third, hold the complete body by grabbing back of the neck by using all fingers. Forceful grasping should be avoided as it is given in figure. Handling of rat. Procedure first, lift the rat out of the cage by grasping the base of the tail and place on the soft surface. Hard smooth surface can make the rat tense. You can follow this technique as presented in figure. Procedure second, place your index and middle finger along the rat head and your thumb and ring finger under its foreleg. Use your index and middle finger to secure its head and the remaining finger to support the body. Both these techniques are presented in figure. Now, procedure third, hold the complete body by grabbing the back using complete palm. You can follow this technique from this slide. Handling of guinea pig. Guinea pigs are very humble rodent and can be easily handled because of their docile nature. Procedure first, by using both hands, calmly grasp it with one hand under the chest and use your finger hand to support its hind quarter. Handle guinea pig with one hand by holding its hind quarter. As the weight of animal is little high, so we should use both hand for better handling. Both this technique of handling is presented in slide. Handling of rabbit. Procedure first, by using single hand, hold the pelvic region. This technique is mainly used to transfer rabbit from one cage to another. Procedure second, by using both the hand, hold the complete hind quarter. It is the easy technique for handling of rabbit. Procedure third, by using the both hand, cleanly grabs it with one hand supporting back of the neck and the other hand supporting its hind quarter. Routes of drug administration in experimental animal. In this section, we will briefly discuss about different routes for drug administration in different experimental animal. Now, feeding or oral gavage. In this section, we describe the procedure of oral dosing technique. For this, hold the rodent in hand carefully. Measure tube length from the nose to the last rib of rodent and mark it. Give a gentle tight grip at the back of the neck so that it opens its mouth widely. If possible, use any hard wooden or plastic gag. Push the rodent head slightly upward and back to straighten the esophagus and then either from right or left side of teeth. Insert the tube by gentle rotation to avoid the resistance. Do not force the tube in esophagus. This may injure mucous membrane. Slowly pass the tube, observing for the swallowing reflex and when desired length of tube has been inserted. Inject solution with the help of syringe. This technique is recommended in mice and rat, but not preferable in guinea pig because they have a small palatal ostium which get easily damaged. Injection site and technique. Injection site should be clean with suitable disinfectant or antiseptic. Sterilized syringe and needle must be used for any type of injection. Always use the smallest possible gag needle to limit tissue trauma and injection discomfort. Aspiration technique is always important aspect before pushing the injection solution at the site. Now, handling of mice and rat. In this slide, you can see different handling technique of mice and rats. Now, oral dosing technique in rats and mouse. For rats, restrain the rats in an upright position using either a V-hold or crossover to immobilize the head and neck. Ensure the animal can breathe freely. The gavage needle is inserted into the left side of the animal mouth and directed along the hard palate of the mouth to the back of the throat. If using a flexible rat rubber feeding tube, the rat can be gently restrained by hand or by wrapping in a towel while they are sitting flat on a table or counter. Gavage tube is inserted into the left side of the animal mouth and gently slid down the esophagus to the proper distance as it is shown in figure. For mouse, gently scrub off mouse for passes of metal gavage needle. Gavage needle is inserted into the left side of the animal mouth and directed along the hard palate of the mouth to the back of the throat. This slide indicates the size, length, ball diameter, volume of the gavage needle. In case of mouse, the needle should be 24 to 20 gauges, and in case of rat, it should be 20 to 16 gauges. Another thing is that greater than the recommended volume should not be given unless justified and approved on the animal care protocol. Another section of this slide indicates metal gavage of needle, plastic gavage needle and rat rubber feeding tube for rat. In this section, we will discuss about various route and technique of drug administration. Now, we will discuss about intramuscular route. Intramuscular injection are often given in the following area, including muscles of buttock, muscles of thigh, and deltoid muscle of the arm. Maximum volume for the injection is 3 ml. Intramuscular route have the advantage such as absorption is rapid than subcutaneous route. Oily preparation can be used. Irritative substance might be given and slow releasing drugs can be given. The disadvantage of the intramuscular route is using this route might cause nerve or bend damage. Intravenous injection. Intravenous injection might be applied to the lateral tail vein. As you can see in figure, the advantage of intravenous route is immediate action, preferred in emergency situation, it preferred for unconscious patient, titration of dose is possible, large volume can be injected by this route, diluted irritant might be injected, absorption is not required. Now, intraperitoneal route. As you can see in figure, the hind quarter and tail should restrain by the assistant and the operator should extend one of the animal hind legs. The injection should be made into the lower left quadrant of the abdomen. In this area, there are no organ except small intestine. Preparation by wiping the area with 70% ethanol. The tip of the needle should be inserted into the intraperitoneal cavity without puncturing the small intestine. The plunger of the syringe should be pulled back to confirm that the needle is not in intestine. Or now, intradermal routes. Intradermal injection are injection administered into the dermis just below the epidermis. Intradermal injection route has the largest absorption time of all parenteral routes. The site of injection should be clipped, depleted before the injection. The test item is injected into the dermis layer of skin and not below the dermis. Take assistance and the person performing the injection should hold the fold of skin and insert the needle nearly flat on the skin so that the needle is in the dermis layer. Injected the test item slowly in the dermal layer as you can see in figure. Now, subcutaneous route. Subcutaneous route might be used for the arm, forearm, thigh and subscapular space and hypodermic needle which is 25 gauze to 30 gauze are used. Advantage of subcutaneous route is absorption is slow and constant. It is hygienic. And disadvantage of subcutaneous route is it might lead to abscess formation. Absorption is limited by blood flow. Example of drug given by subcutaneous route include insulin, adrenaline and norplant. In this figure, we can observe for subcutaneous injection, the angle between needle and skin should be 45 degree and for IV, it is 90 degree. Now, inhalation. Inhalation may be the route of choice to avoid the systemic effect. In this way, drug can pass directly to the lung. Use for gaseous volatile agent and aerosol. Example, salbutamol and steam inhalation. Advantage of inhalation route, rapid absorption, rapid onset of action. This route has minimum side effect, no first pass effect taken place. This method is easy. Less dose is required, and disadvantage of this route is special apparatus is required. Irritation of the respiratory tract may take place. Airway must be patent. Now, topical routes. Drug may be applied to the external surface, the skin and the mucous membrane. Topical routes include an epidermic route. When the drug is applied to the outer skin, it is called an epidermic route of drug administration. Examples include plaster, creams and ointment. Next, epidermic route. When the drug is rubbed into the skin, it is known as epidermic route. Example include different oils. Next is insufflation. When drug is finally powdered form is blown into the body cavity or space with special nebulizer, the method is known as insufflation. Next is instillation. Liquid may be poured into the body by a dropper into the conjunctival sac, ear, nose and wounds. Solid may also be administered. Next is irrigation or douching. This method is used for washing a cavity. Example, urinary bladder, uterus, vagina and urethra. It is also used for application of antiseptic drug. Next is swabbing. Drugs are simply applied in the form of lotion on sutaneous or mucosal surface of buccal, nasal and the internal organ.
Dose calculation for experimental animals. For powder drug, step 1, think of what you have, drug dose, weight of the animals and volume to be injected. Suppose drug dose is 25 mg per kg for mice, calculate the drug dose in multiple of 10 gram in case of mice or 100 gram in case of rat, guinea pig or rabbit. This is for powder drugs. And step 1, next in step 2. Hence 25 mg per kg equal to 25 mg per 100 gram per 25 mg per 1000 gram equal to 0.25 mg per 10 gram, this is for mice, and 2.5 mg per 100 grams for rat and higher weight animal. So we can take 0.25 mg for 10 gram of mice. Suppose this has to be given in the volume of 0.1 ml, then equation 1 we can write equation 1 as 0.25 mg per 10 gram for 0.1 ml. Now in step 3, weighing and dilution of the drug from 0.25 mg per 0.1 ml multiply by 10, that equal to 2.5 mg per 1 ml. If again we multiply with 10, 25 mg for 10 ml, hence the solution should be prepared by adding 2.5 mg in 1 ml or 25 mg in 10 ml solvent, which will give the dose of 2.5 mg for 10 gram or 25 mg per kg body weight of experimental animals. Step 1, so in this case two important things should be kept in mind: strength of injection and its solubility in the solvent. Suppose morphine is available in the strength of 15 mg per ml, students have to use this strength in rat at a dose of 5 mg per kg to show the analgesic activity of drug. So drug dose equal to 5 mg per kg. So 5 mg per 1000 gram, that equal to 0.5 mg for 100 gram, and that is for rate. In this way we can calculate the dose for rat. That means 0.5 mg drug should be administered in 100 gram body weight of rat. Suppose this is given in 0.1 ml volume, then equation 1 can be written as 0.5 mg per 100 gram per 0.1 ml. That means 0.1 ml drug contain 0.1 ml contain 0.5 mg drugs, and that is for 100 gram body weight. Step 2, dilution of injection strength 15 mg per ml. Put 1 ml of drug in test tube and then add 2 ml of solvent in test tube solution A. Now test tube contains 15 mg of drug in 3 ml. Hence 15 mg per 3 ml equal to 5 mg per 1 ml. So 0.5 mg per 0.1 ml. It is equation 3 equivalent to equation 2. So students can use directly 0.1 ml of solution A to provide 0.5 mg of drug in 100 gram body weight rat. So you can give 0.5 mg of drug in 100 gram rat. And in calculation 2, this formula is applicable in most of the cases and used very commonly for calculation of concentration or volume of solution. C1 into V1 equal to C2 into V2, where C1 is concentration of solution 1 and C2 is the concentration of solution 2, V1 is concentration of solution 1 and V2 is concentration of volume of solution V2. For example, suppose you are provided with 50 ml solution of A, 5 mg per ml concentration, and the instructor wants you to make it 10 ml of 3.5 mg per ml. So you have C1 equal to 5 mg per ml, C2 equal to 3.5 mg per ml, V1 equal to A and V2 equal to 10 ml. Apply the formula C1 V1 equal to C2 V2. Then 5 mg per ml into A equal to 3.5 mg per ml into 10 ml. Hence A equal to 3.5 mg per ml into 10 ml divided by 5 mg per ml. That equal to 3.5 mg into 10 ml for 5 mg per ml. Equal to 7 ml. Therefore, take 7 ml of the solution 1 in test tube and make it volume to the 10 ml of by the solvents. The resultant solution will be 10 ml of 3.5 mg per ml. Note the unit, the calculation 3, by applying conversion factors. This step involves our dose 3 mg per kg convert into absolute dose, multiply by conversion factor and convert into per kg. So from mg per kg we can calculate the dose. From human drug dose, also we can calculate the dose for experimental animals. In this case, suppose drug A equal to 100 mg per kg per day. For the calculation, dose will be calculated either for 20 gram mice or 200 gram rat or 400 gram guinea pig or 1500 gram rabbit. As for animal selection, step 1, dose given equal to 100 mg per kg, convert into absolute dose. Human dose given equal to 100 mg per kg equal to 70 into 100 equal to 7000 mg per 70 kg body weight. For 70 kg, 7000 mg. Absolute dose is converted for 70 kg adult. Conversion of absolute dose is important because it keeps the dose as for body weight of animal. Like human, to make easy calculation such as convert dose mg per kg into mg for 70 kg for human. From human dose, also we can calculate the dose for experimental animals. Here another, this figure or this table showing the chart for conversion of human dose to animal dose. Mice 20 gram, you can multiply 7000 into 0.0026. These are conversion factors. For rat, 200 grams, 7000 into 0.018, that equal to 126 mg for 200 grams. So here you can observe, multiply human dose, absolute dose and conversion factors and get the actual dose for experimental animal, that is for mice, rat, guinea pig and rabbit. It is a better way for conversion of human dose to experimental animal dose. In step 4th, then convert into per kg dose according to animals. Mice 18.2 mg per 20 gram, so 910 mg per kg. For guinea pig, 217 mg per 400 gram, so it will be 542.5 mg per kg per day. Rabbit 490 mg per 150 grams, 1500 grams, equal to 542.5 mg per kg per day. From animal to animal drug dose, we can also calculate dose of animal by using animal dose. Mice dose of drug A is 5 mg per kg. Then from mice dose, we can also calculate the dose for other animal. Here, we can see the example in 1. Dose given 5 mg per kg in step 1. Step 2, convert into absolute dose. For mice, 20 mg equal to 5 mg per kg, that is 0.1 mg for 20 gram, means 20 gram is for mice. Generally, weight of mice is approximately 20 to 40 grams. Here another multiplication by conversion factors. Here the mice absolute dose is given and we have to multiply with conversion factors, that animal to animal conversion factor. In previous slide we have seen the human to animal conversion factors. By memorizing this conversion factors, we can calculate the dose for the experimental animals. Here 0.1 into 7, that is 0.7 mg for 200 gram for rabbit. For 200 gram is for rat, and rabbit, weight of rabbit approximately 1500 gram. So multiply 0.1 into 27.8, so it equal to 2.78 mg per 1500 gram. This is the dose for rabbit. Mice absolute dose is given. You can multiply with conversion factors and get the results. In step 4, then convert into per kg dose according to animal from step 3. 0.7 mg per 200 gram, that equal to 3.5 mg per kg per day. For rabbit, 2.78 mg per 1500 gram equal to 1.85 mg per kg per day. In the same pattern, if the rat dose is known, then other animal dose can be calculated by using the above mentioned step with conversion factors given here. Rat 200 gram to mice 20 gram. What is the conversion factor? 0.14. rate 200 gram to guinea pig 400 grams. What will be the conversion factor? 1.74. Rate 200 gram to rabbit 1500 gram. Conversion factor is 3.9. After converting the drug dose to corresponding animal, do as for calculation 1 or calculation 2 for the volume to be injected. You have to calculate the volume. So, in